Hello, good morning all. Let's join the today's live lecture. So, good morning all. Let's join the today's live lecture. Let me know. Harsh, Patil, hi. Prachi, hi. So, you are able to see complete board. Welcome to live lecture, 3D, 20th lecture. Today we are starting 20th lecture. Anishka, hi. Aditya, hi. Siddhant, hi. Vaishnavi, hi. Yes, yes. Nikita, him, hi. Sarayu, Mithali, Swara, hi, hi. So, you are able to see the board, complete board you are able to see here. May I get here that all you are able to see the board? Yeah, good morning, Nikita. Suhana, hi. Yes, Sweta, hi. Prasanna, hi. Yes, yes. So, you are able to see Kaustubh, hi. Yes, yes. Good morning, sir. Good morning, chemistry, sir. Good morning, Shreyansh. Yes, yes. Harsh Patil, hi. Prachi, hi. Swara, hi. Harishka, hi. Yes, 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 yes. Yeah, yeah. Hello, everyone. Hi. You are able to see the board, right? So, yesterday I was discussed about the equation of the planes. So, now today we will solve some 2019 questions. Then after I will complete the remaining point today's lecture. Okay. Now, we are going to solve 2019 some questions, okay? 2019 some questions, I am going to solve it now. Then, we will solve some image of a line, projection of a line, like these things we are going to learn today. So, before that, now we will start solving the 2019 some questions, okay? Let us start. So, good morning all. Let's join the live lecture and let's see the questions. I'll explain you some questions which are very important for JEE point of view and which is asked in JEE 2019. Okay, let's see this question here. The question is, let P be the plane. which contains the line of intersection of the planes x plus y plus z minus 6 is equal to 0 and 2x plus 3y plus z plus 5 is equal to 0 and it is perpendicular to the xy plane. Okay, saying then the distance of the point 0, 0, 256 from P is equal to dash. This is asked in JEE 2019 recent year question. JEE 2019, this is the question we are. Hello everyone, and share in the group, share this video in the group, like this video. And just see here, this is the question asked in 2019. We are discussing some of the questions of 2019. We have discussed already some questions related to 3D in 2019 questions we solved. 2020 we have solved. Now we are solving some of the questions which I feel very important for 2019. That questions I am explaining now. You are able to see the complete board. Audible, yes, audible and visible, right? Everyone, yeah. Let P be the plane which contains the line of intersection of the planes of this and it is perpendicular to the plane XY. Then the distance of the point 0, 0, 256 from P is equal to dash. This is the question. If you want options, I can give you options. I'll give you 1 minute time, you can solve it. If you are able to do it, then I'll explain you, okay? If you want, I'll give the time. Can I continue or can I give the time? You're able to see the complete board. Sriya, hi. Dheeraj, hi. Harsh Patil, hi. So here, this is the question. Let P be the plane which contains the plane of intersection of these two and perpendicular to xy plane, then the distance of the point from the from the P is equal to dash. So options I am not writing here. I'll write it later. Okay. So let us start the problem now. Now, whenever they said that these two are intersection points, so these two planes are intersection. This plane, let us take one, and this is the plane you take as two. So what you can write as x plus y plus z minus 6 plus some lambda times 2x plus 3y plus z plus 5 is equal to 0. This is the intersection. When two planes are intersecting, this is the condition. Family of the plane condition is this. Family of the plane condition is what? If two planes are intersecting, then we can write as first plane plus lambda times second plane is equal to 0. This is the point of intersection of the planes. What I want to say here, if this is the plane, I'll draw the diagram. So this is what the plane, okay? This is what the plane, and you don't have this. Okay, you have only these two. I'll make you clear understanding of this question. So this is what you have. So these are the two planes, okay? These are the two planes. These are the two planes. They are intersecting. Yet this is the intersection point of intersection of the line. Saying that P be the plane, which is containing the line of intersection means P is one plane. This is P is a line I am drawing, but I am not drawing the plane. P is one plane which is containing the intersection of these two planes and perpendicular to XY plane. Then the distance of the point is what? So first of all, you have to find the equation of the plane. Means you have to find this P, P equation of the plane. So how to find that? That is simple thing. We will take this one. It said as it is perpendicular to XY plane. Okay, this is what is given. This condition to be used. Before that, this is I'll make smart. That is, I can write this one as 1 here, X coefficient is 1 and here is 2 lambda. So completely the x coefficient will be 1 plus 2 lambda plus the y coefficient will be here 1 and here will be plus 3 lambda and here will be z coefficient is 1 and here will be plus lambda. Okay, so I made here x coefficient separate and y coefficient separate and z coefficient separate and you have here minus 6 plus 5 lambda is equal to 0. This is what exactly required plane. This is the required plane. Okay. You can make this one as the complete box. This will be better than this one. This will be the better idea. So this is the required plane. And which is perpendicular to XY plane means the Z value is 0. That is the main point here to understand. If it is perpendicular to XY plane, then Z will be 0. That is 1 plus lambda is equal to 0. So lambda is equal to minus 1. It is perpendicular to XY plane. Okay. Perpendicular to XY plane. Means here perpendicular meaning you know na? Right? Means that the DRs are already perpendicular. And X, then this plane is perpendicular to XY plane. Then the Z, the coefficient of Z will be 0. So lambda value how much I got? Minus 1. If I substitute lambda value minus 1 here, I'll get the plane equation. Then I can find the distance of this point on this plane. That is my final answer. Hope you understand what I said. So if I substitute lambda value minus 1 in this, so here 2 into minus 1, that is 1 minus 2 is minus x. I'm going to get here minus x. And if I substitute here minus 3, and I'll get minus 2y, this is y coefficient, right? This is y coefficient, okay. And plus, plus this is minus 1 plus 1 is 0, minus, and here lambda value minus 1, so minus 6 minus 5 is minus 11 is equal to 0. This is the required plane, okay. This is the required plane. And if I multiply this one with negative number, I get x plus 2y plus 11 is equal to 0 is the required plane. And I have to find the this is P is the plane. Plane, I got it. Now I got plane and I have to find the distance. Distance of the point from P. So you have to find the distance from this point. So distance formula applied. You know distance formula, how to do it. So distance from 0, 0, 256 on this plane, which plane? On this plane, the perpendicular distance on this plane, x plus 2y plus 11 is equal to 0. You have to find the distance of this. I'll write, okay? So what will be the distance formula I can use here? The distance formula I can use here is, this is I'm going to write here. I'm going to write here. So you know that zero, this is from where here 0 comma 0. So 0 into x. So you get a 0 plus 2 into 0. And there is no z here. So there is no z. Plus 11 divided by square root of the coefficient of x square plus coefficient of y square plus coefficient of z square. So 1 square plus 2 square, z square is not there. So the answer is the distance of this one will be 11 by root 5. So option D was the right answer. Options I did not wrote. So the distance from this point to on this plane is 11 by root 5. This is the answer. Hope you understand. Sanjay is Shingate. Yeah, hi. So you got understood this one. Sanjay, may I know your name? Yeah, Kaustubh. Yes. May I know this is you understood? You have to find the 0, 0 to 256. From this point to on this plane, you have to find the distance. Formula, you know, na? What is the formula? You know this is the plane and you have a point. Put up the perpendicular formula. Ax1 plus by1 plus cz1 plus d upon square root of a square plus b square plus c square. That is the distance formula. So I applied that formula here. I applied here the formula. Aditya Shingade, yes, yes. Dhananjay, understood, yes. Understood, yes, yes. Riya Parmi, yes, understood, yes, yes. That's great. So great. Let's go for the next question now. Okay. So today's lecture will be very important lecture. You just understand this concept. Today, I'm going to end this main topic and then we are moving into the sphere topic. Sphere with plane. Okay, that will be the end of the topic for tomorrow. Today, let me explain more questions and more concept. If that is understood, then tomorrow will be last. Other, if it's not understood, if it is more, day after tomorrow, we'll complete this chapter. So let us go for the next question here. Dear students, let us start the next question. So the next question is like this. What is saying here? This is again 2019 question. The plane through the intersection of the plane x plus y plus z is equal to 1 and 2x plus 3y minus z plus 4 is equal to 0 and parallel to y axis also passes through the point dash. This is asked JEE 2019 question. Option A, minus 3 comma 0 comma minus 1. Option B, minus 3 comma 1 comma 1. Option C, 3 comma 2 comma minus 1. Option D, 3 comma 2 comma 1. So let's see this question. This question you can solve it or should I explain? Yeah, this question is asked in JEE 2019. The plane through the intersection of the planes and parallel to y-axis also passes through the point. Parallel to y-axis they given, okay? Parallel to y-axis. So how to? Before one is perpendicular. So now it is a parallel, okay? The difference you want, you need to know. That is the reason I pick up this question. Perpendicular was before and this is parallel. Same here, two types of questions. Same question, same model. So what you do here that is important, you should know how to deal these problems. Okay. So what we will do here, it was previous question was the plane and now it is an axis. Now see here what happens here. Now what we will do here, the same diagram of the previous, same thing as it is. Like here you have a plane here and you have another plane here. Okay, these are the two planes, and this is the intersection line. Okay, now what is saying? The plane through the intersection of the plane means these two intersection plane. Plane, you need to know intersection of these two planes. Now this can be not 90 degrees. This is not given. They are 90 degrees. This, I'm drawing this to make you understand. That's it. So it can be like this also. It can be like this. Okay. It can be anywhere. Okay. So here, these are the planes you have. So what we will write here, x plus y plus z minus 1 plus lambda times of 2x minus plus 3y minus z plus 4 is equal to 0. This is the required plane equation of intersection of the two planes. So what we'll write here is 1. The coefficient of x is 1 here. The coefficient of x is 2 lambda. And here the coefficient of y is 1. Here the coefficient of y is 3 lambda. Here the coefficient of z is 1. And here the coefficient of z is minus lambda. And here minus 1 plus 4 lambda is equal to 0. This is what the exact required plane equation. Now when they said us this plane is parallel to y-axis, means this plane is parallel to y, suppose this is the required plane, this plane is parallel to y-axis. Okay, this is the plane and this is the normal to the plane. See, this will be the normals and this is the y-axis. And this parallel to y-axis means they are both are like this normal, like normal means A, B, C. These are the normal, right? X and the I to write Y, sorry, here. Yeah? I did not mention here. Y coefficient this is. And this is Z coefficient. Okay, Z coefficient. So coefficient of X will be the normal to the plane. Coefficient of Y will be the normal to the plane. Coefficient of Z will be the normal to the plane. So these are normal to the plane, perpendicular. And this is, though both are perpendicular, so dot product of these both will be zero. Means the dot of y component, here y component is j. So y axis means this is a j vector. And here this is j vector. The dot of this j will be zero. That means the dot of j will be, this is 1, and this will be 1 plus 3 lambda. That dot product is zero. It means if they say that's parallel to y-axis, the meaning of parallel to y-axis is, this is the plane, and this plane is parallel to y-axis, then the j dot, like y-axis means j dot, j cap is the y-axis. And this vector is ai, suppose ai plus bj plus ck, then I can write as b is equal to 0. It means the coefficient of y will be 0. It means here 1 plus 3 lambda is equal to 0. So lambda is equal to minus 1 by 3. If I put lambda is equal to minus 1 by 3, I'll get the plane equation here. Hope you understand, Tanishka. Yeah. So this is explained. This I explained? Okay, this question is I explained. Okay, fine. Did I explain this question? Okay, then fine. Then move to the next question. So what I have to do here, this lambda value you can substitute in this. Lambda value you can substitute in this, you will get the plane equation. So that plane equation you will get. So what you have to do here, what is, you need to substitute these points on that plane, which is satisfying, that is the answer. I think this is I gave homework, okay. So lambda value substitute in this. I got one equation, suppose like this, I let us assume this one. I got like this, okay, something I got like this. Then I will substitute these points in this. I'll substitute in these points in this. Which point is will give you zero? That will be my answer. So D option will be correct for this one. But I don't know this value, how much you will get. I mean, this plane equation, I don't know. So that you are going to get something. So the answer is 3, 2, 1. If I explain that, sorry, we'll move to the next question. I thought it is not explained. Okay, sorry. Actually, I am thinking that perpendicular is there, so I can explain the parallel one. Okay, then fine. So next question. Actually, 2019, many questions I explained then. Already 2019 questions I was checking yesterday. So I think these questions all I explained. Let me see this question, which I feel different and I did not explain, that only I am pick up.
You just let me know, is this I explained? 2019 questions I am pick up in, that's it. R is 4 comma y comma z. Just see this question. Lies on the line segment joining the points p 2 comma minus 3 comma 4 and q 8 comma 0 comma 10, then the distance of r from the origin, then the distance of r from the origin. Did I explain this question? This is again 2019. Did I explain this question? This is 2000. Actually, I was pick up in 2019. I have seen which I have not explained in the previous lecture that I am pick up. Okay. If I explain this one, then I'll go to the content. I'll explain that image of the line. Okay. And projection of the line on the plane. I'll explain that topic. I'll start explaining this topic. And another point is there, that is I am going to explain. Did I explain this question or not? Let me know. Let me know whether did I explain this question. Can anybody answer? Tanishka here, Nikita M. No, then okay, fine. So let me explain this. Okay, just I was pick up in the 2019. If I may, by mistake, I explained, maybe, I don't know. If a point R lie on the line segment joining these two points, then the distance of R from the origin is how much? This is the question. So you just take this, what is the idea is given. There is a point P, that is 2 comma minus 3 comma 4. Okay. And there is a point Q, that is 8 comma 0 comma 10. So if you join these two lines, it's saying that if a point R lies on the line segment, suppose here R is a point, that is x comma y comma z, is lying on this line joining. Okay, is lying on this. He's saying that is lying. Then the distance of, if a point R x comma 4 comma, sorry, this is not x, this is 4. This is 4, okay. 4 comma y comma z, lie on the line segment joining these two points, then the distance of R from the origin. So you have to find R now. Our main target is to find R. If I want to find R, first of all, you need to know what is the line equation first. Let's find the line equation. If you have two points, then the line equation I gave you, x minus x1 by, what is the formula? x minus x1 by x2 minus x1. Line equation formula, x minus x1 by x2 minus x1, that is 6 is equal to y minus y1 by, y1 is what here, plus 3, by y2 minus y1, that is 3, okay. And z minus z1 by z2 minus z1, that is here 10 minus 4, 6. Are you getting, this is x1, this is y1, this is z1, this is x2, this is y2, this is z2. The formula is x minus x1 by x2 minus x1 is equal to y minus y1 by y2 minus y1 is equal to z minus z1 by z minus z1 by z2 minus z1 is equal to lambda. This is the formula to get the value. So lambda is there. Some see, if we think that this r is the point at a distance of some lambda distance, some parametric form distance. So here, let us take it is equal to lambda. The general point on the line will be, that is x is equal to 6 lambda plus 2, I'll get 6 lambda plus 2. And the y is equal to 3 lambda minus 3. And the z is equal to 6 lambda plus 4. So I got the general point, this one. And these points will be equal because the point is there on the r, this point, and this point is the general point. Some r distance, I took this r, some r distance, some lambda distance. So these points will be equal. So if I equate these two points, that is 6 lambda plus 2 is equal to 4, then 6 lambda is equal to 4 minus 2, that is 2. Lambda is equal to 2 by 6, that is 1 by 3. So I got lambda is 1 by 3. If the lambda is 1 by 3, then I am going to get the value of this r. What is the value of r here? Let me know what is the value of r here. Let me know r value. What is the r value here? This is, I am going to get here 4 comma, and this lambda, if I substitute 1 by 3, 3, 3 will get cancelled, minus 3. If I lambda value 1 by 3, if I substitute 3 ones are 3, 2 gets cancelled, r value is 4 comma, minus 3 comma 6. Is asking the distance of r from the origin. From origin somewhere is there, 0 comma 0, you have to find the distance of r from the origin. That is a square root of 0, this 4 minus 0 whole square. The distance formula of 2 points, 2 points distance formula. That is 4 square plus minus 3 square plus 6 square. That is equal to 4 square is 16, 3 square is 9, 6 square is 36. So the distance formula I am going to get, under root of how much I am going to get? 4 square 16, 3 square 9 and 3 square 36. This is 25, 25 plus 36. I am going to get how much? 61, square root of 61, correct? So this is the distance, okay? So you have the distance, this much is the distance. So this is the way to find it. Sir, it is not minus 3, it is minus 1. Which is minus 1? Which one? Which one? Why? See here, what is they given? 2 comma minus 3 comma 4. Let me see the question. 2 comma minus 3 comma 4. 8 comma 0 comma 10. X minus 2 upon 6. Y plus 3 upon 3. Z minus 4 upon 6. Correct? So what I got here? So here I'm getting how much is equal to 4. Correct? Y value, how much I got? Let me see once. Four minus two. X value 4. 4 minus 2 upon, that's what happened. Lambda value got wrong. See here, let's see one more thing. See here, wait. If it is that much confusion, let's see. So here, you can see that the x value, this line, this is the line. Okay, we will do another way also. This is the line. This line will be passes through this point. This is the line equation. R is the point lie on this plane, lie on this line, correct? If this is lies, what I get here? 4 minus 2 upon 6. This way also we will get. Let's see what mistake I did. 3 is equal to, here I am going to get Z minus 4 upon 6. So if I simplify this, what I am going to get here, if I am simplifying this, that is 2 upon 6. 2 upon 6 is equal to, Y plus 3 upon 3 is equal to Z minus 4 upon 6. 2 ones are 2, 3s are gets cancelled. So what I am going to get up, 1 upon 3 is equal to Y plus 1, Y plus 3 upon 3. One thing I'll get. Another one, 1 upon 3 is equal to Z minus 4 upon 6. So 3, 3 gets cancelled. Y value will be getting minus 2. Okay, minus 2. You are saying that only, correct? Y is equal to minus 2. And if you are cancelling, this is 3 1s are 3 2s gets cancelled. 2 is equal to Z minus 4. So Z is equal to, you are getting 6, correct? Z is equal to 6. So Z is equal to 6. Y is equal to minus 2. For the number is 4, minus 2, 6. So the distance formula is applying under root of 4 square plus minus 2 square plus 6 square. That is 16 plus 4 plus 36, correct? So this will be 56, square root of 56. Is it right now? Is this right? Yes, sir. Yes, square root of 56. Yes, yes. Square root of 56. Yeah. See here, what we can do here, I think you could get from the lambda also, but what I have done, I don't know mistake. So here, x value, if I substitute 4 in this, because the point lies on this line. This point is lie on the line. So I took the general point, that only. Maybe some calculation I did mistake. Here I substitute here 4 minus 2, that is 2 by 6. Cancel out 1 by 3. Equalate these two equations. Equalate these two equations. Y value minus 2. Z value 6. Then you can find the distance formula from the origin. Hope you understand. Let's move on to the next topic. That is image. Projection of a plane and projection of a line. Image of a line. Okay, that we will discuss. Okay, and 2019, almost all questions I explained. If anything is left, you can check it. 2019 questions you have with you. If I think the other questions I explained, I checked yesterday. If I missed out any 2019 question, you post me in the group. I will explain tomorrow lecture. In tomorrow lectures, I'll explain. Because I saw the previous other all questions I explained. 2020 also I explained. If I missed out any question of 2019 and 20, you can post me in the group and tomorrow's lecture I will explain them. Okay, one more question. One more question. This is I not explain, I think. Just see this one. One more question is there. Let A be a point on the line. Let A be a point on the line. R is equal to 1 minus 3 mu, 1 minus 3 mu I cap plus mu minus 1 j plus 2 plus 5 mu k cap. Okay, R is they given that. Let A be a point on the line. A is a point on this line. Okay. And B, 3 comma 2 comma 6, be a point in the space. This is in the space. Then the value of for which the vector AB is parallel to the plane x minus 4y plus 3z is equal to 1 is mu is equal to dash. And this is JEE 2019 question. This is JEE 2019. Options are 1 by 4, 1 by 8, 1 by 2, and minus 1 by 4. Other all questions I explained. I think I missed out this only one question. Yes, Anay Pawar. Yes, Ruti Patil. Yes. I missed out only this question. Other all 2019 questions are explained. Now we have to learn two more concepts in this 3D. Okay. So after this problem, I'll explain the concepts and problems. Let A be a point on the line. So A is one point on this line. And B is the B is 3, 2, 6. Be a point in the space. The value of for which AB is parallel to the plane is dash. Okay, mu is dash. For what value of mu, this will be parallel. That is the question. So, hope you understand this question. Yes? Yeah. You are able to see the board, complete board, correct? Any doubts? You are able to see this question I not explained, right? Did I explain this question? Yeah, no, right? So let's solve this question, right? Let's solve the question that let us take a point on this plane. First of all, let us take a point on this line
and B is the point in the space, and is they said as the direction ratios are given, we have to find the value of mu is how much we have to find. That is our target. Let's see here. Okay. Now what we will do here, I'll explain you. See here, there is a line. A is a point on the line. Okay. B is, suppose I am taking a line. Okay. On this line, a point is there. And B is a point in the space. Space. In the space, B is a point. B is a point in the space, that is 3, 2, 6. And A is the point on this line, right? R is equal to this one is there. So point will be what? What will be the point here? This is in this format. So the point will be what? 1 minus 3 mu, mu minus 1, 2 plus 5 mu. So this is the point on the plane, right? A point on the line, right? This is already in that format. Okay. Point form is given. Already this is the given. So point will be this one. If you are not understanding, I'll explain. This is the point. Did you understand how to recognize the point on the line? This is the point on the line. Do you know how to recognize the point on the line? If you don't know, let me know this. Do you agree this is the point on this line? Let me know when anyone is clear. Okay. I just want to know that whether on this line, this is the point. Do you agree or do you have any doubt on this? On this line, this is the line given. So I am picking this is the point. Do you know this is the point? Array, answer option, yes, yes, yes. Tanishka, answer option is A, you are right. But I want to know, this is the line. On this line, what is the point? How to recognize, do you know? Do you have idea? Yes, Siddhant said yes. Tanishka said 1/4. And now what I was saying, you know, you try to understand. See, here you have a general. Actually, line will be how? How will be line? Tell me. X minus x1 by a is equal to y minus y1 by b is equal to z minus z1 by c is equal to some lambda or mu. This is given in mu, so you can take as a mu. So if this is the mu, so what you write actually in the form here, x is equal to how you write here, x is equal to a mu times of x1. So here, and y is equal to how you will write as b mu times of plus y1. And z is equal to how you will write here, c mu times plus z1. So this is given in vector form, R form, vector form they given, a mu times x1 plus I cap plus b mu times y1 j cap and plus c mu times z1 k cap. They're given like this. So these will be the points on the line. So this is the line actually. And these are the points on the line. This is given directly this one. They're given directly this one. Are you getting it? Actually, exactly if I write this line equation, how it will be? X minus. So this will be by 3 will be there. And you will be having here minus 1. X minus 1 by 3. This line is like exactly if I write like this. Y minus. So you can see this here minus 1 means you will get as plus 1. And you have mu means this is 1. Okay. And here this, if I write this format, z minus z1 will be what? What is the z1 here? This plus 2 you got means here minus 2 and dividing by 5. This is equal to mu form. This is exactly line. Line is given in the vector form. This is the Cartesian form. How I converted? You have here plus means you get here minus. You mu multiples, whatever the mu multiples is there, that will be the drs. That you need to know this thing. So what the thing here is, you understood. Exactly the line equation is this. And given a point on this line, the point exactly if you want to know, 1, 2 is the exact point. I'll tell you that. But if you see from this point of view, the point is this. And if I convert in the Cartesian form, this will become more easy. More easy when you convert in Cartesian form. This is a vector form. So this is vector form. This is a Cartesian form. How to convert it?
You see, this is the sign. You have a plus means you write a minus. You see the product here, multiple. Just see this here. If you go through there, I am getting minus, right? This is I am going to get minus 3. So then only I will get minus mu and plus 1. And then here is I have a 1 mu minus 1. This is correct. Just compare this. 5 mu. Yeah, this is correct now. And now this is the line. Actually, exactly this line is this. And the point is exactly point is what here? Minus 3 comma 1 comma 5. If I write in the Cartesian form. So this is clear now. What is the given? Let A be a point on this line. Means A be a point on this line. So A is the point on this line. And B is the point in the space. If the space in this space B is a point on the space, then the value for which the vector AB, is parallel to this plane. This vector AB is parallel to a plane. What is the plane is given here? A plane is given. For that plane, this AB is parallel. What is the plane here? Let me know the plane. What is the plane here? X minus 4y plus 3z is equal to 1. For this plane, this vector AB is parallel. Okay. Then what is the value of mu is asked? What is the value of mu? This is the question is asked. Okay, are you getting it what I said? Anishka, normal. Yes. Okay. So you are getting what I said? Yes. I hope you understand this. Okay. So you know that this is the vector and this is the norm. So you can see this normal will be like this. Yeah, this will be this one. And this will be here. These both will be perpendicular to each other. Means these both, this if I subtract and this normal is perpendicular to each other. So what you do here, you find a vector, this one, A minus B, you do it. And you have the 1 minus 4, 3. The dot product will be 0. From that, you get the value of mu. That is what you required to find. Hope you understand. What I want to say here, you just find subtraction of these two vectors. You get a vector and the normal will be here. The dot product of both will be 0 because normal is perpendicular. This plane perpendicular, these both will be perpendicular. Hope you understand. Let me solve this question. I just made it to understand this. Whenever vector is there, how to find Cartesian form. Let's explain you clearly. This is very important. Okay. People will not understand this point. It's very important point. Okay. Now I can subtract these both. I can subtract AB vector means nothing but B minus A. Okay. So B minus A means 3 minus this one. 3 minus 1 minus 3 mu. Okay. And another point I'm going to get as 2 minus mu minus 1. Okay. Another point I am going to get as 6 minus 2 plus 5 mu. So what I am getting this is, see, you can write as minus 1. 3 minus 1, that is 2. And here minus into minus plus. Okay. So plus 3, 3 is a 9 mu I get. Hope you understand. 3 minus 1. This is minus, right? Okay. Sorry. 3 minus 1 plus 3 mu. Okay, 2 minus mu plus 1, 6 minus 2 minus 5 mu. I just multiplied minus, where is there? Inside I multiplied minus here. So what I am getting here, 2 plus 3 mu, and here I am getting is 3 minus mu, here I am getting is 4 minus 5 mu. And this and these are perpendicular to each other. This vector is this plane and this line is parallel. It means this normal is perpendicular. It means this into this will be dot will be 0. That is 2 plus 3 mu into this coefficient is 1 plus 3 minus mu into minus 4. Okay. And this dot will be 0. That's what I want to say. So if I make the dot is 0, I am going to get the mu value. That is your final answer. Okay, what I am doing here, 1 into 2 plus 3 mu and plus this minus 4 into 3 minus mu, okay, plus 3 into 4 minus 5 my mu is equal to 0. You just simplify this, you will get the value of mu. That is 2 plus 3 mu minus 12 plus 4 mu plus 4 mu plus 12 minus 15 mu is equal to 0. You can get the answer from this. Okay. So this minus 12 plus 12 cancel. If I not did any clock calculation mistake, you will get definitely answer. 4 plus 3, 7. 7 minus 5, 8. Right? Minus 8 mu plus 2 is equal to 0. So minus 8 mu is equal to minus 2. So mu is equal to 1 by 4. Option A is the right answer. So this is the way to deal. This is the JEE 2019 question. Hope you understand this answer. So he's asking to find the mu value here. So mu value you got 1 by 4. Understanding the concept is important, not the question and answer. Hope you understand this. I took a lot of time to explain because there are many things to understand from this question. That is the only one reason I pick up this question, I explained. In 2019, almost I covered all questions. Now let us move on to the image and what is the projection? Projection and image of a line on a plane. Okay, let's discuss that last and another one more point also there. So let us discuss that and then we will move on. Right? Hope you understand this concept, whatever I said. Understood. Kaustubh said understood. That's great. If you understood, that's fine. Great. Great to hear. So other things I explained. Still, if you feel in 2019 and 20, I missed any question you feel, you can post me in the group. In tomorrow lecture, I'll explain that. Okay. Okay, now let us discuss the concept here. That is the main concept. Then I will explain some questions. Exactly questions I'll explain. So image of a line. Image of a line. It's not a point. We discussed the point, not a line. Okay. Image of a line in a plane. In a plane. Now we are going to discuss these questions also. Same questions I'll discuss, not other questions. So many questions are there. We have questions. I will give the questions homework to you also. Okay. We will discuss them. Okay. Now the thing is here. They given the image of a line in a plane. How to find? There will be two types of lines in a plane. See here, we will have two things. Suppose this is the plane. Okay. And the line is going like this. Means the line will be intersect the plane. Okay. The line will be intersect. This is the line L1 and this is the plane P1. And another way will be scenario will happen. This is the plane. This is the plane. And the line will be parallel. Okay, parallel. So both examples I'll give. This parallel one already JEE asked in the previous year. And this one they asked in advance. This is asked in mains. This is asked in advance. So these two conditions I'll explain. So P1 is a plane, that is AX plus BY plus CZ plus D is equal to 0. And L1 is a line, that is X minus X1 by A is equal to Y minus Y1 by B is equal to Z minus Z1 by C, this scenario. And if these things are parallel condition, I'll explain, don't worry. Parallel is very easy. Parallel one is easy. And the main thing is this one, okay? So if I want to find the image of this line on the image of this line in this plane, okay, if I want to find the image, how to find that? Okay, that we are going to explain now. Suhana, yes, yes. Sriya, yeah, done. Yes, Prasanna, Aditya Shinde, yes. Now what we are going to learn is image line in a plane we are going to learn. And there are two types of things will be there. One is parallel, one is intersecting. There is no other thing will happen. ना एक प्लेन से और एक लाइन से इसके और दूसरा सिचुएशन नहीं हो सकता है ना. ये प्लेन इस ए लाइन ए प्लेन को कट कर सकती है या ये प्लेन इसको कट नहीं कर सकती है, वो पैरेलल हो सकती है. दैट्स इट. सी ए प्लेन विल बी इंफिनिटी, राइट? प्लेन इज इंफिनिटी. इफ इट इज नॉट कटिंग मीन्स इट इज पैरेलल. इट विल कट और इट विल बी पैरेलल. ओनली दो टू सिचुएशंस विल बी देयर. ऑन दिस बोथ सिचुएशंस आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट प्रोजेक्शन and image. What we are going to discuss? Projection and image. what is the projection of this line on this plane? What is the image of this plane, image of this line on this plane? That both things we are going to learn. First, I wrote about image. Then we are going to learn about projection. Both the things we will learn. Okay. So, for a time being, I'll erase this part and I'll explain here. Okay. So, I can explain there. So, I'll get the space to explain it. So, this is very important concept I am explaining, and this is this type of questions asked in 2019 also, 20 also. So, these things, it is must and should. You should know these things. Okay. How to deal these problems means there are 3 points to be observed. Okay. One is what here. So, how we will find the equation image will be, see this. If a line is intersecting on this plane, means I will have a point here. The point will be, this point will be on this plane. Means if a line is there that is intersecting this plane, it means the one point must be there on this line, on this plane. Means if I find the intersecting point P here, my work will be done. Okay, that how to find, I'll explain. I'll explain with example. Now I am just explaining the theoretical part. And one more thing is, we will take a general point on this line. Line means line you have. See that x minus x1 by a is equal to y minus y1 by b is equal to z minus z1 by c. This is what the equation of the line. Okay, you can take lambda or you don't take. So this will be point, actually x1 comma y1 comma z1. So this is the point on this. So if I find the image of this image, if I find image, and you know the plane equation is given, that is ax plus by plus cz plus d is equal to 0. A plane is given. If I take a point, line is given means plane given, line given. Means the point on the line I know. And if I know the point on the line and I have a plane, I can find the image. How I will find the image? First, I will find image of the point. Image of the point. Image of the point. Point on the line to the plane. Image of the point on the line. On the line to the plane. Okay. I'll find what was first. I'll find image. So if this point is A, I'll get A dash. I'll explain with example. Wait. I'll explain the example. That time you'll understand. I'm explaining the theoretical part. Then I'll find the point of intersection here. Point on the plane. Point on the plane. Okay, then this I'll explain. Then third point, what I do? I have these 2 points. I have these 2 points. So this will be the image. So you know 2 points are there. You can find the line equation. Using two points, I'll find the line equation. I'll find line equation. That will be the image of this line on this plane. That will be the image of this line on this plane. This is what we will do exactly. Understood? If I want to find projection, I explained the projection questions also. You can use this also, this method also. If I want to find the projection of a line, if I want to find projection of a line in a plane, then what I'll do here, I will find the foot of the perpendicular. Instead of image, I'll find the foot of the perpendicular. Let us take, in this case, I'll find foot of the perpendicular. So I'll find foot of the perpendicular. After finding foot of the perpendicular, I'll find the point on the plane. I'll tell you with example. Okay. I'll find the point on the plane. Then I'll find the distance of this. Suppose this is the P and this is M. Then I'll find PM. So that PM will be the projection of the plane, the projection of a line on the plane. So if I want to find the projection, I use this condition. If I want to find the image, I use this condition. Let's do some problem. Then we will move on to the parallel. Parallel is most easy one. Parallel aisa hi aata hai. So parallel is most easy one. So what I am going to do here, the image and projection of one question I'll take, I'll explain this both, so you will understand in better. Okay, let us pick up the question and solve it. I hope you understand this concept. Concept is this. Let's solve the question based on this. Okay, if the brightness is required, let me know. I can increase the brightness of the this class if you want, because it is there now in my hand. I decrease the brightness. Reason I felt you will not able to see the questions. So here, let's solve the question which I explained it. So based on this, now I am going to explain the question. Okay, let me explain the question on this topic, whatever I explain. So the question is here follows. Let me explain the question so you will understand. Find the equation of the projection of the line. Projection, can I explain? Image. First, I'll explain image. Image of the line, x minus 1 by 2 is equal to y plus 1 by minus 1 is equal to z minus 3 upon 4 on the plane, x plus 2y plus z is equal to 9. I'm going to explain this now. I will explain first image, then I will explain projection. Both I'll explain. So both work will be done. Okay. Now what I am going to explain is the projection and image. Both I am going to explain. So I explain you theoretical part. If you want to try yourself, you can try and find out the answer for this. Okay. Are you getting it? Is it clear? Now I increase some brightness. Is the problem? Can I decrease the brightness? Is it okay now or can I decrease the brightness? Can anybody answer me quick? Is it okay now? Should I need to increase the brightness? Decrease. Okay, decrease. Okay, fine. Yeah. See now. Okay. Decreasing, sir. Yes, sir. Now it's okay, I think. Now see the question. Now I am going to discuss these two questions. So you will understand what exactly I was saying here. Okay. Now let us discuss this. Find the equation of the image. Okay. Now same question is there. The question is here. This is the plane they given. The plane is what here? X plus 2y plus z is equal to 9. And there is line is given. So this line is going like this. How we'll come to know it is a parallel or it is intersecting? Just do this. You multiply these both. If you are getting 0, then they are parallel. If they are not getting 0, then they are intersecting. That is the only thing you come to know. Is this intersecting or not? Both I'll explain. Okay. Both I will explain. So I am explaining first which is intersecting one. How I come to know this is intersecting or what? You just take this. This is the direction ratios. And these are the direction ratios. Multiply them and see 2 into 1 plus minus 1 into 2 plus 4 into 1. If I check this one, 2 minus 2 plus 4, there is no 0 here. So they are intersecting. This line and plane is intersecting. If I get 0, then they are parallel. Okay. Then they both are parallel. Okay. Now I come to know they are intersecting now. Now, let us find the things. Now, what is the general point on this plane? General point is what here? 1 comma, not general point, point on this line. 1 comma, minus 1 comma, 3. Correct? This is the point. So first, what I told you, you should find the image. You have to find the image. So let us find the image first condition. According to the formula, x minus x1 by a is equal to y minus y1 by b is equal to z minus z1 by c is equal to minus 2 times of ax1 plus by1 plus cz1 plus d upon a square plus b square plus c square is the formula for the image. So what I do here, x minus, this is 1 upon a is 1, that is equal to y minus, y1 is plus 1 divided by b is 2 is equal to z minus z1. Those who are joining live, share in the group, like it. Okay, z minus z1 is 3 upon c is here 1 is equal to minus 2 into a is here 1, 1 into x1 is 1. Okay, plus b is here 2, 2 into y is how much? Minus 1. 2 into minus 1. Okay, 2 into minus 1. Plus, what I am going to do here, plus c is 1 into, and here 3, plus lambda, na, plus d. D means if I send 9 this side, minus 9. Divided by a square plus b square plus c square. 1 square plus 2 square plus 1 square. 1 square is 1, 2 square is 4, 1 square is 1. So I am going to get the image now. Everyone knows how to find the image. So I am not just clearing much here. X minus 1 by 1 is equal to y plus 1 by 2. Okay. Y plus 1 by 2 is equal to z minus 3 by 1 is equal to minus 2 into, let me see, is this question is 1 minus 2 plus 3 minus 9 divided by, this is I am going to get 6. So 2 ones are 2, 3 is the gets cancelled. So x minus 1 by 1 is equal to y plus 1 by 2 is equal to z minus 3 by 1 is equal to, this is minus 9. See this one, minus 9 minus 2. That is how much? Minus 11, correct? Minus 11 plus 4, minus 11 plus 4, that is equal to 7, correct? Is it correct? 7, right? 3 plus 4, 4 minus 2, 2, yes, yeah, 7, correct? So minus 7 I get, minus into minus plus 7 by 3. So what I am going to get here is, x minus 1 is equal to 7 by 3, y plus 1 by 2 is equal to 7 by 3, z minus 3 upon 1 is equal to 7 by 3. Then x is equal to 7 by 3 plus 1, y is equal to, so this is I am going to get how much? 3y, right? 3y, 3y plus 3 is equal to 40. And here 3z minus 9 is equal to 7. So finally I am going to get the value, x is equal to, image I am going to get here. X is equal to, so 3 ones are 10 by 3. 10 by 3. Comma, here 14 minus 3, that is 11, right? 14 minus 3 is 11 by 3. 11 by 3. And this one is 9, if you add 7 plus 9, 16 by 3. So I am getting this one, okay? I am getting this one. So this is the image I got. So I got the image. Now I will find the point and then we can find the equation of the image. So actually this question was projection. This question was projection, but I made image and projection. Reason is you should know both. So hope you understand this one. Is it your understanding? Is it this is understanding? Yes. Is it you are understanding this? Yeah, others understood. Yes. Sir, CN sir, please don't message like that. Okay. Yeah. So here x is equal to 10 by 3, 11 by 3, 16 by 3 is like this you have. Okay, then what you can find now, the image you got, you just find a point on this, then you can find the equation of the plane. That's it. So image you got, right? You got the image. That's great. So can I erase this point? Yes, sir. Siddhant, very good. So image I got, so I'll erase this one. So I got the image. Now image is over. So image is done. Now what I can find here? I have to find point on this plane, right? I'm telling the theory how to do the problem. Exactly this question will not come. I change the question. So that is the reason you get difficult values here. Otherwise, the values will be very beautiful. So how to find the now point here? Just simple here. You have this line, right? You have the line. So take it is equal to something lambda. Okay. So what is the general point I get? X is equal to 2 lambda plus 1. Okay, you should know this theoretical, this point, how to find it. And the y value will be how much? Minus lambda, minus 1. And z is equal to how much? 4 lambda, 4 lambda plus 3. Okay. So x is equal to 2 lambda plus 1. Y is equal to minus lambda minus 1. Z is equal to 4 lambda plus 3. Now, these points are there. And these points, this point is will be this one. So that will be satisfy this plane. So this point satisfy the plane. So I am going to get this point now on the plane. So the point on the plane that is from r distance away, the lambda distance away, that is 2 lambda plus 1 comma minus lambda minus 1 comma 4 lambda plus 3. This question is advanced level question. See, 3D geometry, what questions will be lengthy, but concept if you understand, which is very easy. Sometimes they will give easy questions, sometimes they will give difficult questions. I mean, difficult question means lengthy questions. And this is not related to board, okay? Image of the point is there. Image of the point in a plane is there for the board. But image of the line is not there for the boards. So now you got this point. This point will satisfy this plane. So substitute here 2 lambda plus 1 plus 2 times of minus lambda minus 1 plus z is 4 lambda plus 3. This is equal to 9. So I can find this point satisfy this line. Okay. So 2 lambda minus 2 lambda minus 2 lambda cancel out. So what I am getting here, plus 1 minus 1 gets cancelled out. 4 lambda is equal to 9 minus 3. That 4 lambda is equal to 6. Lambda is equal to 6 by 4. 2 3s are 2 2s are. So lambda is equal to 3 by 2 I got. So lambda value, if I substitute, I'll get the point on the plane. So lambda value is 2 into 3 by 2 plus 1. Okay. 3 by 2 plus 1. And here minus 3 by 2 minus 1, 4 into 3 by 2 plus 3. This will be the point. So 2 ones are cancelled. So I get here 3 plus 1, 4. And then here I'll get here minus 5 by 2. Then here I'll get 2 twos are cancelled out. 2 threes are 6 plus 1, 9. So I got 2 points now. I got the image. I got the point on the plane. So now you can find the line equation. So line equation. See, actually the question also, in this book also, they're given in the fraction. Answer is given in the fraction. So you are getting in fraction because the question was difficulty level, advanced level. So the question is in fraction. So if you want, I'll post after this lecture. Okay. So this is the way you should know, first of all, how to find point on the plane and how to find image of this. And you got these 2 points means your work is done. So what is the image of the line? Image of the line means 2 points are there. What are the points you have here? One point is 4 comma minus 5 by 2 comma 9, and another point is 10 by 3 comma 11 by 3 comma 16 by 3. Then the line equation, this question I created. So actually the projection was the question. So the answer will be, image of the line will be, image of line will be, the answer is x minus x1 divided by y2 minus y1, that is 10 by 3 minus 4 is equal to y minus y1, that is plus 5 by 2 divided by 11 by 3 minus plus 5 by 2. This is equal to z minus z1, that is 9 upon 16 by 3 minus 9. This is the required line image. So you can simplify this, that is the final answer. Answer also given in the fraction only. So this is, if you simplify, 3 fourths are 12. So 3 to 4s are 12 means minus 2 by 3 is equal to y plus 5 by 2 divided by, you can simplify this, you will get the answer. That is 3 twos are 6 is the answer. 3 table 2 times. Okay, so 22 plus 2 table 3 times, 15, that is equal to 37. And is equal to z minus 9 upon, this is the 3 is the LCM, 16 minus 9, 3 is the 27. So I am going to get here is minus 11. So this is the image of the line. Okay. This is the image of the line to the plane. Hope you understand, everyone. This is what the image of the line. Okay. Concept, try to understand how to find image of the line. It is an advanced level. Image of the point will be mains level. Image of the point, foot of the point, that is the mains level and boards level. But image of the line, projection of the line also, JE level, JE mains and advanced level. So this is, you understood I hope you understand this. Now let us discuss about projection now. We will discuss about the projection. Hope you understand, everyone. Yes, yes. We are going to, this is the last concept because the time is also over. So I'll explain about projection. Then we will end up this section tomorrow and day after tomorrow. And day after tomorrow, we'll finish this chapter at any cost. So, okay. Hope you understand. Let's move on to the projection concept. Okay. Image is over, done. Image is done. Let's move on to the another concept, that is what we called as projection. Okay, students, let's start now. So this is done. Now for projection, what we will do? See, I'll tell you orally, then you will understand. If I want to find the projection of a line, there will be two methods for projection. There will be two methods for the projection. Anay Power, thank you so much. Yes, Sayansh understood. That's great, great, great deal. Great going on. Like now here, if I want to find the projection, and this is the mains and advanced level projection, if I want to find, what I do here, this is the line. Okay, this is the line. And what is the general point on this line is 1 comma minus 1 comma 3. Correct? 1 comma minus 1 comma 3. If I want to find the projection, you just find the foot of the perpendicular. Foot of the perpendicular. There is another method I explained you in the previous lecture also, one JE question. Another method is what? I'll explain you both the methods if you want. If you are willing, that is the method will be useful and is the important one. This will be make you easy way. Projection sum I explained you 2001. What is this? You know, you have this done, then this is the direction. Normal to this plane. So normal is what? What is the normal here? 1 comma 2 comma minus 1. Okay, this will be normal. Another method, if you want, I'll explain. But first, let me explain this method. Then we will go to the another method. And sin theta formula. Already I explained that one. But let me explain this method. Okay, so this is the plane equation. And this is the point on the plane. Okay, this is the point on the plane. 1 comma minus 1 comma 3. Then what you do here, we will find first foot of the perpendicular. First foot of the perpendicular. What is the formula? X minus x1 by a is equal to y minus y1 by b is equal to z minus z1 by c is equal to minus of ax1 plus by1 plus by1 plus cz1 plus d upon a square plus b square plus c square. This is called as foot of the perpendicular. Foot of the perpendicular. So if I use the foot of the perpendicular, what I am going to get here? X minus x1 is 1 upon. The second method, why I'm explaining, means this method, the numbers will get fraction. So finding distance formula will be difficult. It's easy, both are easy. Let's see here. X minus X1 upon A is 1. Y minus Y1, that is plus 1 upon 2. And Z minus Z1, Z1 that is 3 upon, and this value is 1, is equal to minus of what here? 1 into 1, that is 1, I'll write directly, and minus 1 into 2, that is minus 1 into 2, that is minus 2, CZ1, C is this is 1, and Z1 is 3, 1 into 3 is 3, and minus D, D is if I send this side, minus 9, divided by A square plus B square plus C square, 1 plus 2 square is, this is 1, 1 square plus 2 square plus 1, that is 4 plus 1. From this, I am going to get foot of the perpendicular. That is x minus 1 upon y plus 1 upon 2 is equal to z minus 3 upon 1 is equal to this. I am going to get as minus 9 minus 2. This is how much I got? Minus 3 plus 4. 4 minus 2. 4 minus 2, that is plus 2. 2 minus 9 minus 7. 7 upon, I am going to get 6. 7 upon 6. So the x value will be minus 7 upon 6 plus 1, y value will be y plus 1 by, so this is, we will equal it, okay, we will equal it, so we will get the value of x. So from this x, I am going to get as minus 1 upon 6, 6 1, the LCM I am doing here, okay. Now here I am going to get y plus 1 upon 2 is equal to minus 7 by 6, I am equal to 2 1s or 2 3s are cancelled, 3y plus 3 is equal to minus 7, so 3y is equal to minus 10, so y is equal to minus 10 by 3 I got. So the foot of the perpendicular I am getting, that is minus 1 by 6 and minus 10 by 3. And then I am going to get another point, z also. So z I will get here. I will equate these both, I will get z. z minus 3 upon 1 is equal to 7 by 6. So I get as 6z minus 18 is equal to minus 7. So 6z is equal to minus 7 plus 18. That 6z is equal to,
okay, my God, 3 and 8, I think 11, right?
8, yeah.
So 3, 8, 9, 10, 11.
So z is equal to 11 by 6. 11 by 6. I got the foot of the perpendicular now. This is the why we will use the another method, cos 90 minus theta. I explained you this. Another method is there that will be very easy shortcut. And this will be lengthy. Okay. Because this, you know, foot of the perpendicular. I got the foot of the perpendicular. Okay. But the numbers are odd, like here fractions are there. Now we will find the point on the line. Already we find the point in the previous sum we have find here 2 lambda plus 1. We have substituted here. We find this point. How much can anybody answer me? We find the point on the line. The same way we find, or how we find? We already find the point on the line. So then we will find the distance formula. Then projection is over. Projection is nothing but distance. So how you will get this distance? See, students, this foot of the perpendicular I got. Okay. Are you getting it? The foot of the perpendicular you have here. This point, how you get here? 2 lambda. Can anybody answer me? This point, what I got? 2 lambda plus 1. See this one. 2 lambda plus 1. Minus lambda minus 1. Minus lambda minus 1. 4 lambda plus 3. This I substitute in this plane. I got the lambda value. And I substituted here. I got the point also. Can anybody say what was the point I got? Yes, sir. It is 9 by 6. Sir, it is not minus 7 by 6. Which one? Okay, we will see. Concept you understood, no? Let's see here. What I want to say here, lambda value, how you get lambda? Lambda, how? I find the previous lecture, lambda. Can you tell me? In the previous, just I explain you the lambda, but I erased. The point I explained you, no? How to get the point here? 2 lambda plus 1 minus lambda minus 1, 4 lambda plus 3. That will satisfy this line equation. 2 lambda plus 1 plus 2 times of minus lambda minus 1 plus 4 lambda plus 3 is equal to 9. From this, I got the 2 lambda minus 2 lambda plus 1 minus 1 cancel. 4 lambda is equal to 6. Lambda is equal to 6 by 4. That is 3 by 2. 3 by 2 substituted here. You got the point. What was the point here? 2 into 3 by 2 plus 1. Minus 3 by 2 minus 1, 4, 3 by 2 plus 3. If it is any mistake is there, I'll tell you. What you get foot of the perpendicular is? The foot of the perpendicular, how much you got? They did not do this method. Another method they did. Okay. So here, the foot of the perpendicular you got, no? This one you got. And this one you will get. 2 cutting this one, 4. And this one I get minus 5 by 2. And this 2 is cutting here. 2, 3 is a 6 plus 9. And just use the distance formula. The distance formula will be the projection. If you apply the distance formula, that is the projection. But this is taking a lot of time calculation. So instead of this, we will use lambda is 3 by 2. Correct. Lambda is equal to 3 by 2. Yeah, lambda value 3 by 2. I substituted and I got this one. So you will find the distance formula, that is the projection. But this is becoming difficult, right? This is becoming difficult. So shortcut method is there. What is the shortcut method? The shortcut method is, instead of doing this all the nonsense, we can do another way. What is that here? You have a plane that is x plus 2y plus z is equal to 9. And then this we will take as the normal. Okay, normal. So then you know, we will find the point on this point. What is the point I got? I got the point is 3 by 2. I substituted. How much I got the point? I forgot the point. I find the point now here. What was the point I got? Yeah, point how much I got? Can anybody tell me what was the point I got? Lambda is 3 by 2 I got. I substituted lambda is equal to 3 by 2. In this, what do you get? 2 lambda plus 1. minus lambda minus, unnecessarily I am arising that one, minus lambda minus 1, and this one I got as 4 lambda plus 3. So here I got 2 cancel, 4, minus 3 by minus 5 by 2, comma. I got another one is here. This is second method. Method 2, I am telling you. Method 2. This is here. If I substitute 2 table, 2 times cancel, 9. So this is you got. What we will do in method 2 is, in method 2, what we will do, we will subtract these two vectors. And you have this vector. And this is the projection I need. And this is a vector I have. The projection of this will be, if I take this is the point P and this is the point Q, the projection of this will be PQ cos theta. We'll use this one. Projection of this will be PQ cos theta. I explained in previous lecture once. So we will find PQ distance. PQ distance we will find. So distance formula we will use. And cos theta, how we will find? Cos theta we will find. This is the normal. So normal one will be what here? 1 comma 2 comma 1. 1 comma 2 comma. This means I plus 2j plus k. Okay, this is the normal. And this is the normal. And if I subtract these two vectors, I will get another vector. That is PQ. That is the cos. This is what we called as 90. This is theta. This is 90. And this is 90 minus theta. Angle between them, these two vectors is, that is cos 90 minus theta is equal to, we use the concept, PQ dot, this is the 2018 question. This model one question asked in 2018 that I explained in the lecture also. PQ dot with this n vector, this n vector. PQ dot n vector upon mod PQ dot mod n1. We use this condition, so I get sine theta. Sine theta is equal to, I get this dot this, means this is, you have to subtract first. If I subtract this one, PQ equal to what? PQ is equal to Q minus P. This is the method 2 I am explaining. Okay. 1 minus 4, that is minus 3. Okay. And minus 1 plus 5 by 2. That is, I am going to get as 3 by 2. So I am going to get 3 by 2. And next one is 3 minus 9. That is, I get minus 6. And the dot this, which is dot this one dot with this, this dot this, that I am going to get here, how much here? 3 ones are 3, minus 3. 3 by 2 into 2, that is 3. Okay, dot, we are doing dot here, plus we'll get. 3 ones are minus 3 plus 2 into 3 by 2 is 3 and 1 into minus 6 is minus 6 divided by magnitude of PQ. This is whole square root of. Actually, this question is hard question, means like fraction question. If I pick up the easy question, that would have been better. Minus 3 square plus 3 by 2 whole square plus minus 6 square. And square root of this one will be, n dot will be 1 square plus 2 square plus 1 square. So I get sine theta value. Already PQ means PQ, how you will find distance formula we will apply. However, both are looking same thing only. Method 2 also feeling difficult only. You use the distance formula here. 1 minus 4 whole square plus here minus 1 plus 5 by 2 whole square. And here plus 3 minus 9 whole square. Distance formula we are applying. You will get PQ distance here. This is, you can do it. I am giving you homework. PQ distance you will get. From this you will get sine theta. If you know sine theta, use the right angle triangle condition. Use the right angle triangle condition, you get the cos theta. So then PQ into cos theta will be your final answer. This is the method 2 to find the projection. To find the projection, so we will find PQ distance formula and we will find the cos theta. You get the cos sine theta. Cos 90 minus theta is sine theta. But then using the right angle triangle, or you can use the another way, is that sine theta you know. So cos theta will be under root of 1 minus sine square theta. So sine theta you know, then cos theta will be what? Square root of 1 minus sine square theta. Using this you get cos theta. So PQ into cos theta, PQ distance into cos theta will be the final answer. So these are the two methods you have to find the projection or image. Image I already explained you. For projection, you can take foot of the perpendicular. I think the method one was very easy for this question. We find foot of the perpendicular, we find the point on the line, you find the distance formula, over. Distance formula will be done, over. In method 2, what you are doing, we find the distance of these two points, and then we will find the angle between two planes, these two vectors, this vector and this vector, angle between these two vectors, and then we will multiply this distance into the angle value, that will be the projection. Hope you understand all. I think you have a chemistry lecture. So all you can take care and bye-bye. And go and join to the chemistry lecture. This is the way to deal. Tomorrow I'll explain more questions. The last concept. In 2 days, we are going to finish this chapter. Thank you so much for joining this live lecture. Thank you so much. You can join the chemistry lectures. Yes. Everyone, bye. Take care. And we will have in 2 days, I'm going to finish this chapter. And yes, bye. Bye, sir. So here, I hope you all understood this lecture. Okay. Hope you understood all. So this question, I pick up the hard question. Like the thing is, what fraction is more involved in this? Take care. Bye-bye, everyone. Join the physics lecture. Oh, sorry, chemistry lecture. I think you have a chemistry. I don't know which lecture you have. Physics lecture is not chemistry. Okay, Sriyansh. So is it going to start? Is it started, Sriyansh? Is the physics lecture is started? So what is this? This is the way to do it. So you can do this one, right? Is it confused, this last one? Last one, everyone understood? Everyone understood, right? Okay. I cannot waste your time. You can join the physics lecture. Yes. Thank you so much, everyone. So take care. Bye-bye. Those who have joined newly, you can subscribe the channel. Yes, that's great. Okay, bye-bye.